Hi, it's Kirsten from the Annapolis Maritime Museum. I hope you all are doing fine, staying safe and healthy at home. I hope you're taking advantage of every chance you can to go outside, keep yourself from going stir crazy. Like many of you, I am stuck at home, but I am here to show you that even though we're stuck inside, we can still do some pretty cool science experiments with some stuff that you probably have lying around the house. Today's experiments have to do with buoyancy. Now, what is buoyancy? We're going to talk about that after our first experiment, but basically we're looking at whether or not things sink or float. On our first test, we are going to use an egg. Now, I don't know if you've done this test before. This is actually one of my favorite life hacks. Do you think our egg is going to sink or float? Let's see. I have a cup of water here. I'm going to put it in. And if you see, our egg is sinking. Now, I said this is one of my favorite life hacks, and that's because the reason our egg is sinking is because it is fresh. You can tell if an egg is good or bad, fresh or rotten, by whether or not it floats. When an egg is still fresh, it sinks at the bottom. Now, you can see that this egg, while it's sinking, is standing up a little bit. The fat end of the egg is pointing up. This is an older egg. The expiration on the box actually says March 20th. So we are actually past its expiration date. I am filming this on March 27th. We are already a week past its expiration date, but it is still good. It's not floating. And that's because expiration dates usually are not they're not based as much on science as they are on laws, making sure that people don't get sick. So oftentimes foods are good well past their expiration date, which is a good thing to know when you're living off pantry staples. So my egg is fresh because it's not floating. But like I said, if you look, it's pointing up a little bit. If I swap it out for an egg that is more recent that we just got, this egg is white. It just depends on the breed of chicken that lays the egg. White and brown eggs actually have the same nutrition, the same flavor, the same everything else. It just depends on the breed of chicken. But if I put this egg in here, it does in fact sink because, again, this is fresh. But if you notice, it's actually laying flatter on its side. When eggs are super fresh, they lay horizontally. And as they get a little bit older, they begin to tip up with the fat end pointing up. They're still good, but they're a little bit older. Once they float, that is when you know that they're rotten and that you can't eat. So if we look at our brown egg again, I'll put it back in and I'll start with it kind of on its side, and you can see that it naturally tilts itself back up. So why is that happening? How can we tell that an egg is fresh based on that? Well, an eggshell, even though it doesn't look like it, actually is permeable. So that means that it has really small holes, and gases are able to be exchanged between the outside and the inside of the egg. Now that's really important because if our egg was fertilized, if there was a baby chicken there, it needs to breathe. So it needs to have that exchange of gases. What that is allowing our egg to do is, as our egg gets older, it's losing moisture through evaporation. So water is leaving our eggshell, and air is taking its place. On the fatter end of our egg, there's an air sac, and that air sac gets larger as the egg gets older because of that moisture loss. If there were a chick inside, it would actually use that air sac right at the end before hatching to get enough oxygen to have enough energy to hatch, which is really cool. But that means that as there is less water and more air in our egg, it is more likely to float, which is really cool. So what is buoyancy? We said it's whether or not something sinks or floats, but what is affecting? Obviously, we know that the weight of something affects whether or not it sinks or floats. We can think about really heavy things sinking and really light things floating. And as our egg is losing moisture, it's becoming lighter, so it makes sense that it's going to float. But weight is not the only thing that affects whether or not something sinks or floats. If we think about boats, they're really big and really heavy, but they still float. Right? So we can't just think about the weight of something. We have to think about the volume of it or the shape of it. How much space does it take up? If you noticed, when I put my egg in the glass, and I'll take it back out so you can see, the water level actually went up. The water level is starting right here. When I put my egg in, the water level has gone up to here. It goes up. And that's because our egg is displacing an amount of water. The amount of water that it displaces is the same as the volume of this egg. If we were able to take that water and make it egg-shaped, it would be the exact same size as our egg. So how do we use volume and weight to determine whether or not an object will sink or float? Well, it's actually pretty cool. If we look, when an object's in the water, there are actually two forces working. The first is gravity forcing down on our object. Now, the heavier our object is, the stronger the force of gravity. On the other end, we have the buoyancy force. And the buoyancy force is actually the force of the water pushing back up on our object. In order for something to float, the buoyancy force has to be stronger than the force of gravity pushing down. If something sinks, that means that it is heavier than that buoyancy force. In the middle here, we have something a little bit weird, and this is something called neutral buoyancy. So it's not floating on the top, and it's not sinking to the bottom. It's kind of sitting somewhere in the middle, and it can easily move through the water column because the two forces are exactly the same. Now, what determines how strong each of these forces are? Well, it has to do with density. So density is the mass of an object divided by that object's volume. Now mass, for our purposes, is pretty much the same as the weight. So if we took the weight of the object and divided by the volume of the object, we get that object's density. So if we look at our bowling ball here, they've put the bowling ball in this cup of water, and it is displaced this much water. Our bowling ball is 4.5 liters. That's its volume. We're doing things in metric, and you'll see why in a second. It's going to make math a little bit easier. Our bowling ball is 4.5 liters. Because of that, the volume of water it displaces is also 4.5 liters. It is the same. Now, we want to find the weight of that water that was displaced. Now, the reason they used metric here is because it makes the math really simple, because 1 liter of water is equal to 1 kilogram of water. So if we have 4.5 liters of water, we know that that weighs 4.5 kilograms. Now, we said our bowling ball was 4.5 liters, the same as the volume of our water, but our bowling ball weighs 5.5 kilograms, which is more than the weight of the water, so it sinks to the bottom. I think we all knew that bowling ball would sink, right? Now, if we can imagine if we had a beach ball instead that was the exact same volume as our bowling ball, its volume would still be 4.5 liters, so it would still displace 4.5 liters of water, and the weight of that water would still be 4.5 kilograms. But if we had a beach ball that was filled with air instead of being heavy like the bowling ball, the weight of the beach ball would be much lower, and so it would be less than the weight of the water displaced, and it would float. It's actually pretty simple when you break it down and look at it, which is pretty cool. Now, we realize why our egg is floating. The weight of the water, why it's sinking, because my eggs are not rotten. Why it's sinking is because the weight of the water it's displacing is less than the weight of our egg, so it's going to the bottom. But I want to do a second experiment. What I have here, it's a little bit cloudier, I'm not sure if you can tell, is some salt water. It's a little bit cloudier because I've added some salt in. So we're going to take our same egg that we know is fresh because we just tested it, and we're going to put it in the salt water and see what happens. Take a look. Our egg is now floating. And that's pretty cool. And why is our egg floating? What happened? The egg didn't change, right? The mass and the volume of the egg have stayed the same. Our egg has not aged long enough in this couple minutes to lose water, right? It's still the same egg. But the salt water is actually denser than our fresh water. Because we've added salt in, we've kept the volume of water the same, but we've increased the mass of that water. So thinking back to density, we've increased the mass, but kept the volume the same. So the water is now heavier. So in comparison, our egg is now lighter and it's able to float, which is really cool. Again, if it looked like this in just normal tap water that didn't have salt in it, this would be a rotten egg and we wouldn't want to eat it. But if we put it back in the fresh water, we can see that it sinks it just floats in the heavy salt water, which is really cool. So let's review. In order for an object to float, the amount of water that it displaces, which is determined by its shape and its volume, how much space it takes up, the weight of the water it displaces has to be more than the weight of that object. Keeping this in mind, a cool experiment that you can do at home is you can go and gather things from around your house, or even gather some things from outside, and make some predictions. Make a chart and see whether or not you think each of those objects is gonna sink or float. And then you can test it in a bowl or a cup if it's small and see if your predictions are correct. Some items actually surprise you. They're actually end up floating when you think they're gonna sink, or they sink when you think they're gonna float. Even though you understand the principle behind it, it's still always cool to see what actually happens. So that's my challenge to you. Go make some predictions, find some things around your house and outside, and see what sinks or what floats. I'd love it if you report back on your findings, especially if there's anything super surprising. Thanks, I hope you continue to stay healthy and enjoy these little lessons that we are providing, and we hope to see you when things calm down. Bye.